don't put that in the video.
Definitely
do. But you can put it in the blooper. A blooper. Ridiculous.
So anyways, moving on. Value for money. Like, do you think that the money that you're paying is equal to or close to the value that you're getting from the school? Like, think about term one till now. Like, do you think the amount that you have grown, the support you have received, is up to the money that you're paying? Because this money is not chicken change.
So, okay, so first of all, Switzerland is a really expensive country. Taking that into consideration and taking into consideration everything, like, CCRS is a big brand and they have to make, like, a decent profit. I feel like it's kind of justified, like, we're not always happy, but it's kind of justified how much they're charging us. We're in Switzerland and it's a huge brand, so, yeah.
I guess, yeah.
Seems like, I mean, but you're paying for the brand.
No, but like, okay, at the same time, they could do more things to keep us happier, mm-hmm. but...
So taking into account that...
Such as?
They give us food, kitchen. They give us dorms.
Full board, so, okay, kitchen. Yeah.
Full board, full, like, eating everything.
Housekeeping.
Housekeeping, laundry. Although there's sometimes...
Classes.
Laundry, nice. Don't we have to pay?
No, laundry
we don't.
Pay.
Laundry for chef jackets, we don't.
That's true. But chef jackets, like the linens on our bed and
but they make us pay for our own laundry.
Yeah.
But we have to pay for our own laundry. But, like, if you take into account what they give you,
yeah.
they could do a little bit more to justify the price mm-hmm. in terms of, like, our actual classes and, like, making sure that we get the ingredients that we ask for.
I think also the like the clubs and the
student life, student
like,
life.
Yeah.
Yeah. Also,
we have to, we kind of have to rely on each other to like actually make plans. Like the school doesn't do anything in terms of student life.
Yeah.
So we
and
have to figure out our own plans, make time with our own
and
friends.
And if they do, it's quite expensive.
Yeah, but also even like simple thing like a gym. We have.
I was gonna say
gym.
That.
Yeah.
yeah, we don't have.
It's not
really
a gym.
It's
not
a
gym.
It's like
what,
doesn't even have a treadmill.
15 minutes to the gym center, and they don't even give us transport like only what, 3 times
a week. Yeah, and it's
like
really inconvenient time.
Yeah, you need some people like going to gym every day, and sometimes it clashes with your schedule.
Yeah.
So simple things like that.
Yeah. So like they tell you like Monday what is it,
Monday Wednesday Friday.
Monday Wednesday Friday. So if you have service on 2 of those days, you end up going to the gym.
Exactly.
And also it's like at the same time as dinner, and in place like where we are in a small city, it's tough to get dinner after a certain time.
Yeah.
Yeah. yeah.
And like there's a concession of you can eat before, but no one likes to eat before they go to the gym. Like I feel like if they
yeah,
let you take
that?
Food, like you, they know you're going to the gym, they let you just take one of those packs. You can eat later when
like
you get
the
back.
Midterm, like the trip packs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Then at least you feel like you're being like your like it's more provision for you and stuff like
but
that.
But it's not healthy, right? It's just a sandwich.
No, even if you can just go to the gym and take like salad
no,
and take some. I want to talk about like what are the major positives and the major negatives you feel like you have gained from living here? Like going to school in CCRS, like what about like IRF? What about, then we talk about the quality of student life here, but then also like the lake, like what do you think, what are the two extremes?
Internships are nice.
Okay, go.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Start.
Yeah,
internships are nice. I mean, good contact. it's good contact that you get from people, and I don't know. Negatives.
Contact, yeah?
We need a student kitchen.
True, guys. This is such a big point. We are culinary students, and we do not have personal kitchens. Like I remember, term one, we had to turn potatoes to practice, and we bought like 6 packs of the potatoes in that whole term to turn.
Oh,
we turned them all and threw all
and
the potatoes away.
Them.
We could not cook them.
Like it was what, like a good 12 kilos?
Yeah, it was so much, like so much potatoes.
We tried to boil them with the kettle water, but that didn't end well. So,
and like we need to practice. We would like to cook for ourselves. Like it also helps you be more healthy when you can control what you're actually eating.
I once deboned a whole chicken, and I like begged people who lived in apartments to, you know, use it because it's clean chicken, but
exactly.
No one wanted it, so we have to throw all this
you
stuff.
You want the chicken in your room?
Mm-hmm. She went to Chef Patrice.
Oh,
is it fine?
Yeah, it's fine.
You see, Chef Patrice always there for us.
He's actually the best. So, like that, yeah, we need kitchens, guys, please.
Like,
what were we talking about?
Highs and lows. Most positive,
so,
most negative.
Okay, let's just say most positive. You meet a lot of people from a lot of different parts of the world. Like if you go to a normal college, like say any like one of the top 10 colleges in the UK or something, you won't meet people like such a diverse population.
Yeah,
you won't have it. And
well, like 18 nationalities and 30 people.
Yeah,
like
very random people, like people from all kinds of places. It's true though.
Yeah, no,
like
no,
he's
no.
from Saint Martin. Who would think that?
everywhere. Like
look it up.
Like you'll have a person from every particular. Like every region. I agree with that.
Cyprus.
That's true. Yeah, like did you know Cypriot was a word? No, I didn't. what was I talking about? Highs and lows. Other things. So, we live by the lake, which is really nice.
It's really beautiful, guys. Yep. That's the thing about Bouvray.
Really, really nice. But the lows are, it's a really, really small place. So there's nothing much to do as college students, so we have to rely on each other as entertainment. So we've got a few clowns here.
Hence my room being the communal center, community room.
Yeah, but if you've got friends as clowns like I do, it's perfectly fine. Yep.
For like,
you rock your life.
it's a compliment. Okay.
Ooh, I have one.
Uh-huh.
So I think the good thing is, okay, one thing is we live in a very small village, as she said, but the positive is that we get to be very close. You get to know people very well as compared, okay, I don't know about university, but in a university there's so many people and you might not be as close-knit as you get when you're in a small college.
Especially
true.
Culinary
and we
college.
Have, we have smaller class sizes.
Yeah.
Also
because all of our classes
university.
Are together.
Yeah,
we have a different equation.
Very small, so pretty much everybody knows each other and it's very close-knit.
Exactly.
And I think that's a very good thing considering the kind of industry we're going to. So it's very good. The downside is that, guys, you will learn to be like, find joy in being alone.
Like this?
You will need to know how to manage your time because it reaches a point that like, sometimes your friends are busy and you're alone and you're just gonna have to learn to be alone.
Mm-hmm. Right, are we doing it? It's like retiring at 20.
Yes!
Right?
This
place is we need a hug. Not from you.
That's recorded forever on YouTube now.
I would say highs are you get a lot of exposure because it's in an international school. So, like, I never knew what jollof rice was until I met Moyo.
Thank you, Jesus.
Nigerian jollof for the win.
Exactly. Oh my God!
But, like, now I know what that is. And she educates us on what proper jollof looks like.
And we educate them what is proper way to say. Africa, okay, it's a continent.
Thank you.
Continent.
Thank you very much.
And then we educate Moyo on how to make chapati and stuff of that sort.
Yeah, Moyo, please.
But
that,
yes,
that
you get.
We understand.
You get a lot of international exposure. The laws are definitely that we live in like a dot in the world, so.
It's not a dot.
Literally, we have three things to do with our pastime.
It's a bacteria.
And that we can't cook for ourselves.
Yeah, okay. I don't want this video to be too long, so I feel like we should just go
to
like
two.
Debunking some. Okay, true, we can
yeah.
actually divide into two, so let's just keep going. But let's debunk some myths about culinary school. I feel like everyone feels that culinary school is super easy. You don't need any intellect to be able to be here. Like, all you need is just the passion to be able to come in here and then you just do whatever you want to do. They think it's expensive, but it's super easy to pass. Is that true?
No,
it's a 40% pass for culinary.
Okay,
guys.
I would say
40%.
Okay,
pass.
It depends on how you look at pass. If it if it's passing for the marks or passing for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Like a lot, like 90% of the people can pass for the marks, but passing for yourself is a different thing. Like, what have you learned the whole term? Like, what I don't know. Basically, what have you learned the whole term? It depends. But if you can easily pass, but what to pick up yourself is a different thing.
Do you actually become a proper chef? Like, if you just pass, like, you go into industry and be
anyone
curious.
Can do that.
But Stuti, I feel like grade boundaries need to be higher in the school. Hospitality has 60%, and we're
well,
at 40.
Because Washington State and Derby. I don't think
that's 40 is too less. They don't fail people. They don't kick them out of semesters.
Yeah, and
fail.
I feel like that hurts us because you have some people who really should not be in your term or in your term.
Yeah, like you don't
and
know how to distinguish yourself from the good and the bad. You're just, everyone is just there. There's no one who's good and who's bad.
It's like, you know, when you're in secondary school and they just like, let them go, don't worry. When they get to university, they'll figure it out. But this is university. Mm-hmm. Like, you cannot just be pushing people on, like, for no good reason. It hurts us also because our terms are like, yeah.
No, but it's,
even
okay.
I'm running out of time at this point.
I don't think you need preliminary
knowledge. Okay.
Like, you don't
true.
Need to do a course
true.
Before you come
true.
Here. You don't need to do, like, you don't need to be sitting down in your kitchen all day to be coming to culinary school.
Mm-hmm.
Because the first thing they teach you here is, like, how to chop salads, how to chop herbs, like, that kind of stuff. But as long as you have the will to be better and to do better and, like, even, like, up till date, like, I don't think any chef stops thinking, like, how can I be faster? How can I be more efficient?
Mm-hmm.
How can I cut this in a more delicate way or whatever. Like, there's always room for improvement in the world of cooking, I think. So if the person doesn't have that drive, they should be dropped, I think. I don't think that they should be passed on, you know.
I think one thing you need to learn about our industry is that you need to accept failure, because there are just times you will just fail and fail and keep failing until you just learn from it. But that's how you learn. But that's cooking. You try and make something new and it'll fail. Before you get it right, you fail like 60 times. Honestly. It's like Gaga. He took forever to get that simple whatever thing he made.
The yogurt explosion.
He failed so many times to get it right.
Who is this?
Gaga. But when he got it right, it becomes such a big thing. So fail away, people.
Yeah, don't be afraid of failure.
Sorry. Anyone want to sponsor me to go to Gaga and keep going? I'll have a Facebook page, contact me.
Yeah, this is cool. Like, you asked me to be sponsored.
So last thing then, we're going to do like what tips do you have? Before we do, what tips do you have for people going to culinary school? Let's talk about practical exams. So what do you guys think about the practical exams we have here? Like, are they challenging enough? Are they like what people think? Like, you know, MasterChef, like, let's go. Like, 1 hour, run around, chop, chop your finger off, bandage, you know?
I mean,
is that how our practical exams, like pressure tests, things like that are?
I don't think so.
I think so. It depends. When I first joined,
that lady is just crazy.
For exams, I think it depends. Like, before I joined the school, I actually had to ask someone, is it like MasterChef? Will you have pressure tests and mystery box challenges? It's not like that.
Chill out.
Yeah, it's which is a good, I mean, yeah, it depends from person to person, but I'm glad it's not like that. What was the question?
How is it then?
Oh yeah, so it depends on what term you're in, but for the first year when you're in school, the practical tests are, I mean, you have practical tests, but in the rest of the school, oh shit, I don't know what I'm saying.
The rest of the terms,
you don't have practical tests as such. So, I mean, it depends on how used to are, if you've worked before and everything, but for someone who's never hadn't worked before the term one and everything, it's actually like a pressure test in term one and then remaining term, like till term three at least.
Yeah, I feel like term two is a bit more chill.
Term two pastry was very chill.
Yeah.
Garde manger term three was very chill. You had so much time.
Yeah, but garde manger, I feel that you don't have time. In pastry, you have time if you mess up to do it again. Garde manger, even if you mess up, you can't start again.
Because everything
like,
is a long amount of time.
You have to cope with your mess up. Like, you have to find a way to serve your mess up.
I feel like it's your group because your group was big.
Yeah,
we had time to do again,
and you had resources also. Like, we didn't
like the peas were finished.
You guys were such a large group, we were such a small group.
That's also with our with the school in general, our classes are very, very small. Like, our class only has 7 people, but their class has like what, 13?
13 people.
13 per class, and we have
so
three
we have,
groups.
And in term 3, we had 4 groups.
The less people you have in a class, the more attention that you're giving, the more resources you have to work with.
Yeah.
It's much more easier to, like, if you mess up, you can do something again.
Mm-hmm.
If you need to talk to the chef about something that you're unclear of, he has more time to give each student, you know? But, yeah.
Okay, yeah.
But when you're in term 4 and 5, like, as you come back from internship and everything, you have like a proper fine dining scenario. You're doing, you're getting all kinds of ingredients, you're doing all different kinds of platings. All of your friends have different kinds of exposure levels. So it's quite interesting after that.
Yeah,
because you've gotten the real life situation.
Real life.
Yeah.
But
and everyone comes back very efficient. So it's very interesting to see.
When you go for that internship, you will be smacked with a good dose of reality, because how you're treated in school,
man,
is
a lie.
It's not how you're gonna be treated in internship.
It's a lie.